You've just received your One X Player 2 and are ready to get started. You've unboxed your device, you've plugged it in, and went through all the Windows setup screens. Now you're wondering, what the heck do I do next? Don't worry, I've got you. We'll cover installing your first drivers and Windows updates, testing your controllers to make sure they're working correctly, and finally installing your game stores and other nice-to-haves. After setup, I'll show you where you can find ongoing support and community, as well as general information and video tutorials. All right, let's dive into it. The first thing you're going to want to do, if you haven't already, is test the controllers, make sure that they fit nice and snug. Next, we'll press the button on the bottom right to test out mouse mode. Now we'll head to Gamepad Tester to test the controller. We'll start with ABXY. Then we'll check our triggers for full press. And then we're going to check all of our other buttons to make sure they're working. Now that you've tested your buttons, we'll move to the joysticks and test the circularity. You should expect a 0.2 result. Just spin them around a few times and you should get that result. If not, you'll need to calibrate. So we'll do one at a time, then we'll do the next. It's perfectly normal to take a few rotations. So let's finish this up. For the next part, if you have a keyboard and mouse, it'll make things a lot easier. I'm gonna switch over to my screen capture for this next section. We'll grab the Windows updates first. If there's gonna be issues with it, better sooner than later. So we'll click download to all. Some may require clicking again. Once they're all downloaded, you just need to reboot and let them install. It should go smoothly. Now we'll move on to our AMD Adrenaline drivers. So we're gonna search AMD Adrenaline and open the software. We'll click quick setup and then skip. The software is gonna lie to you and say that it's up to date, but we're gonna click check updates and you'll see there's a new version, so we'll download that. Once it's finished, we'll click install. After this, it's gonna detect your hardware and pop up a new menu. To be safe, click advanced options and make sure that factory reset is not clicked. And now you can go ahead and click install. You can expect your display to flicker, flash, and also to switch to portrait. My screen capture cut out before this finished, but once you're done, you just need to reboot. Now that you've got it installed, you can open up the AMD Adrenaline app. So one thing, never go to this performance tuning tab. Don't touch memory optimizer. You will mess up your VRAM. One area of the app that you may want to check out though is the display tab. So you click your internal display. And if you go to custom color and enable it, you can actually do some color tuning. You can adjust the temperature, brightness, hue, contrast, or the saturation. You could probably turn the saturation up just a little bit and the colors will pop a little bit more. There's other settings for RSR, but I'm not going to go into that today. You'll want to look that one up yourself. The next upgrade is upgrading the OXP Player Center to the One X console software. To do that, we need to grab 7-Zip, so Google 7-Zip and then click the first link. And then we're gonna download the 64-bit Windows version. Once it's downloaded, you just need to run it and it'll install. Now that we've got 7-Zip installed, we can go to the One X Player website and grab the One X console software. You can find the website by right-clicking on the OXP Player Center app and clicking on Visit Official Website. You'll want to scroll down to the bottom of the page and click download firmware. And now we're going to select our product as One X console. So you're going to download the software. And then what we're going to need to do is use 7-Zip to extract it. Go to your downloads folder and right click on the One X console file. And we're going to extract it into a new folder. Before you install it, make sure you right click on the OXP Player Center app and click exit. Now we can open the folder and just run the One X console exe. When you're installing, make sure that you click on for anyone and not on for me. It needs to be on for anyone so it can overwrite the old software. Now we can open up the game launcher and press the corner icon. And you'll want to click on check for updates. There's likely an update available. Now we can go ahead and click install and close the software and we'll come back to it later on. We're gonna install Steam and Xbox. We'll start with Steam first though, so Google search Steam powered, then click the first link and press install Steam. After it's installed, you'll need to sign in. If you want big picture mode, we'll go to Steam and click settings. And then here you can enable Steam to start in big picture if you'd like, which for those that don't know, it's the SteamOS-like UI. You can return to normal by pressing the Xbox button and clicking power, and then you can exit big Steam mode. For the video demonstration, I'll quickly download a game, so let's grab Celeste, and we'll exit Steam for now. We can set up Game Pass now. It's already installed on your computer, you're just gonna need to download an update. Once you've signed in, surprise, surprise, there's another update, so let's install that. After all that, we can finally get started with installing our favorite game. It's super tempting to stop and just play it now, but I'm going to resist that and carry on. Now that we've got some games installed, we can go back to the One X console. We'll press Y and click scan. It should find Celeste from Steam and Peppa Pig from Game Pass. And now we can launch our games from the One X console. Our first nice to have software is Battery Bar, so we're going to Google search Battery Bar, and then we're going to click go to download. And then we need to scroll down to the bottom and click for the free trial. Once it's downloaded, you just need to click the file to run it. Once you're installing, you want to make sure that you click Battery Floating Toolbar so that you can move the battery around and place it wherever you'd like on the top of your screen. Before Battery Bar will appear, you need to reboot your system, or you can go to C, Program Files, Battery Bar, and then hit the Battery Bar EXE and it'll pop up now. Our next software is FX Sound, so we'll Google search FX Sound and click the first link. Then just click download for free and run the download. It'll install. Here you can select your speaker and you can select different equalizers. You can right click on the FX Sound icon bar to change settings or exit. To add 40 Hz to your display, we're going to Google custom resolution utility and we're going to click the link. It's in the description. After that, we're going to click download for Windows, then pick your region. Once it's downloaded, we're going to go to the downloads folder and we'll unzip it with 7-zip, extract it to its own folder, open it, and we're going to run it. Next, we're going to click the top detailed resolution. We're going to double click it and copy. And then we're going to go OK. And we're going to click add detailed resolution. And then we're going to click paste. And then change the refresh rate to 40 and press OK. Press OK again, and then you can reboot your system. Once you reboot, you can double check. And if you go to display settings and go advanced display, you should see a 40 Hz option. Whether it's for support or just to connect with others, I'll show you a few social options. So the One Netbook Discord is a great place to connect. There's the One X Player 2 channel where people discuss the device or different tips, support needs. There's a support channel, a known issues channel, and ask for a mod. You can talk to one of the server mods. In the One X Player 2 channel, make sure the first thing you do is come and say hi, introduce yourself. There's also staff members that show up as admin. They'll have One X Player in their name if they work for the company. And then there's pinned options. This is a great place to find different tutorials or different messages that were important that has been pinned by a mod. You can also find a community on Reddit for the One X Player subreddit. You can find different frequently asked questions, different posts about maybe issues that people are having or solutions they found. It's a great place to ask questions. So you can just create a post, ask a question, or drop a link if you found something useful, or just chat with others. If you're more active on Facebook, you could go to the One X Player Facebook group. There's quite a bit of activity on here, people posting videos, tutorials, questions. So whatever your social preference is, there's lots of options here, whether it's Discord, Facebook, or Reddit. Check them out. I've left the links in the video description. The last section of this video is for guides and tutorials. So first up, you can go to the One X Player store and visit their frequently asked questions page. So there's a lot of options for the One X Player 2. You can look at how to download the BIOS, how to enter BIOS, restore your device, and many other short tutorials that'll give you a visual sense of what to do. There's also a section that shows you some tutorials for the One X console that just came out. So if you're having issues there, you can check this section first to see if One X Player has put a solution here. If you're more visually inclined for learning, you can always check out YouTube. So there's my channel you can always check out. I have a number of tutorials for the One X Player and handheld consoles. So check it out, see if there's something that might be helpful for you. And if you're interested, I started to do some shorts for my console collection, so feel free to check that out. Another YouTuber you may want to check out is The Fox. He's got some tutorials, he's got a lot of reviews of different handhelds. He also goes through AutoTDP, which is an alternative to the One X console software. So check out his channel and consider subscribing. Next up, we've got Retro Game Corp. He's got a number of reviews and tutorials for handhelds. You'll get to see some handhelds that maybe you haven't heard about. So check him out, subscribe. He's got some great content. Next up is Gamers Generation. So check out some of his product reviews. He's got some tutorials for different mods. And I recommend checking out his Nreal Air review. And don't forget to subscribe. If you're interested in handheld content, you'll also want to check out Taki Udon's channel. He's got a lot of previews, reviews, and just cool little projects that he's worked on. So check it out and throw a subscription his way. Hopefully this tutorial was helpful, and that's going to do it for this one. So check out one of these other two videos if you're interested in more content. Thanks for watching.